map of Syria, sure. And as you know, for me, I believe that borders, it should be not political borders, it should be according to your culture. How much you can with your ethics arrive, it's nice because you respect the other when you arrive there. So Syria actually was in that week, you can say west, some west of Turkey, southwest, Iraq, onto the Arabian Gulf, Sinai Peninsula also. For that, the kind of rooms will be different because different climates. Should we have to start here because we couldn't talk without alphabet? So Syria actually gave the humanity the first alphabet. It was about 29 symbols, letters. But sure, when we read it, we will see it's 30. Why? Because the letter C or S seen twice. It has two characters. And also, you can say 40% has Arabic words. So maybe it's the root of Arabic. But then in Ebla also discovered older than this, not alphabet, sure, language. Was also so similar to Arabic also. And sure, the difference is letters. And as you know, before the alphabet was as a photo, as we say. Until now, actually we use it like when you look at that exit photo, there's a man like going out. So we need it sometimes for some people who couldn't read Dutch language or English or Arabic. So the alphabet make so easy. And I think the first reason was the trade. Because if you want to write, for example, how much I need to put in my storage, like how many goods, containers, let's say. So in the beginning was all about trade, numbers, something like that. And also in Ugarit, in Syria, on the seashore, we gave the first, let's say, completely note, musical note. It's religious, actually, note. I'm sure there are musicians, I'm sure, musicians, so they can read it. And sure, no time to listen to it, but I can send the link by email if you could. It's so simple, sure. And also this Syrian man who recode or who read this note by from the tablets, he translated to Doremi and etc. And this is Mary Kingdom. It's, you can say, northeast of Syria. She will talk more details about it later. But it gave many things. We see perfumes and something else also. What is this?
Purple.
Really? Why I put it to you? By mistake or what? Let's discover what this. Okay. So this is a joke here. Finishing boat was going to, or like sailing, you say. So this is French. So the people there, they said, are we going to Rome? Like Bush, you know? Said, no, we are finishing, like finishing from Syria, even all this Mediterranean area. And we sell clothes which come like purple, or I can say. I tried to find, actually, let's say the Barsachtig road is more similar than Bars, I think, a little bit. It was sure in, yes, between 14th century to 15th century before the Christ. And here we have architect, Syrian architect, which built many things in Syria and in Rome, actually in Italy also. Apollodor, his name is Apollodor. Sure, a lot of Syrian philosophers, even medicals, we say, doctors, a lot of Syrian, and some queens, like Julia Dumnia from Homs, for example, was also in the Roman age. Also, we have, let's say, pyramids, Syrian pyramids. Actually, but sure, it's smaller than what we are seeing in Egypt, Sure. Also, those were as tombs or graves, let me say. Yeah, really, it's so similar when I visited there, and there's also Amrit in Syria near to the Ugarit. You will feel that you are in, like, in Mexico, in Maya culture, with the stones and the trees, let's say. We have mummies also in Syria. This mummy, I think there is about 6 or 7 in Palmyra Museum. You can see them also. Mm-hmm. And in that day, it was a big deal of that. Who taught how to make mummies, Egyptian or Syrians? So they're still talking. For me, it doesn't matter because it's mummies. Yeah. We have a so famous city in Syria, Hama. Hama city is so much famous about water wells, actually. And as you know, all rivers in the world always down, you know. And if you want to make farms, you have to make it more high to avoid. Yeah. So for that, okay, if we avoid to the water, then how you give water to the trees, the plants? So those will take the water like upstairs. And there's a lot of videos how they make it and how it works. And I think there are more than 100 of water wells. And I think before I left Syria, about 30 or 40, like, noch wirken, still wirken. And this is Malula, which Mr. Dick talked about it. Sure, still people there talking Arabic language. And if you're really good in Syrian dialect, Lebanese dialect, you can get Arabic or Syriac, Syrian a little bit. Because to is come. Also in Syriac. Syriac, not Syrian, sure, Syriac is 500 BC. And it's so nice there. Maybe the first time I was there, I shocked that I was listening to the Quran from the church, and I asked, why? So the priest woman or the nun, you say? Yeah, she was cleaning and she said, I like to listen to the Quran while, especially it was Friday. So it's so nice life there, actually. Sure, we have in Syria about 84 citadels in different areas. This is near to Homs. This is near to Raqqa. This is Aleppo Citadel. Sure, in Aleppo. This is interesting for me actually and for Dutch people. There is this man, Van Cornelis de Brauw. He was troubled actually. He visited Aleppo also and Palmyra. So he made this painted, and now we are working to make like a story, like because it's about 15th century or 17th century. So we made that in another person in Amsterdam. Like we made 3 periods. Like I was talking about the modern period, how Palmyra look like right now. And in that period of Brown, and also in the Roman age, actually. This is Aleppo. Yeah, this is complete because it's bigger. So here you see the Aleppo Citadel, actually. Sure, here you'll see Arabic. This book actually talking about celebration which happened in Aleppo or in Damascus, I think, in 2008. This celebration talking about 400 years about the first council in the world, like embassy, between Amsterdam and Aleppo. Sure, it was echt embassy. Why? I mean, Aleppo man or woman stayed in Amsterdam, and Dutch man or woman stayed in Aleppo. So it was the first embassy in the world, actually. I found it in French, this book. I'm still searching about Dutch or in English. Because I think there is in Dutch, sure, yeah. Sure, the theater in Busra, it's, I think, until now, the biggest theater, or like let's say the most completely theater in Roman age, which back to Roman age. And this is also theater in Palmyra. I'm sure a lot of concerts happened there. Ephemeral musicians from Europe, from Arab world, they were playing music here because summer in Syria is so nice at night. Yes, it's maybe 30 degrees, 35, but there's always air, no stop. So for musicians, it's not nice sometimes. If you are walking, you see like because of the air, as the car went past. This is Palmyra, which also the brown made it, let's say. It's really talk about that period, it's nice. This show will maybe in this painting is better. Here it was from a church, it's near to Aleppo, Simon, according to the a monk or priest. He was so good man because he was just worshiping like upstairs, and people give him water, or his students maybe, and all from Arab Christians and from also from Europe, they will came to him as to for blessing, for like that, to ask him to pray for them. Show this mosque, Umayyad Mosque, the great Umayyad Mosque, it's in Damascus. And here, sure, as you know, when Muslims make wudu, ablution, maybe we say, when you take water before the prayer, and that dome also is to collect money to poor. So every year there's a man, he open it, how much gold or coins go, and then he will share it to poor people. And also show Muslims believe Jesus will come here. And here we have a Mamluki period style in Aleppo Mosque also. It looks as in Egypt because it's Mamluki also more in Egypt. Ottoman also work a lot in Syria, Ottoman period. There's Al-Adliya in Aleppo. And sure, you will see the minaret as a pen because to always remind lazy students, hey, study, this is a pencil. Really, that was the, one of the targets in it as a pencil. The first mall in the world actually was in Aleppo, which covered 7 kilometers, and it has many streets, small streets. Sure, the smallest maybe 500 meters here for gold, here for clothes, here for shoes. Some market just for women, some for men. So it's amazing. But unfortunately now you can say between 40 to 50% destroyed. We have also this church in Aleppo also. It is also damaged, unfortunately. This area, I think all from Aleppo they like it because we like to eat food there. Mm-hmm. There is a nice shop for food, it's traditional Aleppo food or Syrian food. Also another church next to that one, also in Aleppo. Also it's one of a lot of examples about the old houses. Like my grandmother has like that, maybe many Syrian if they are here. Their grandmother, grandfather, they have like that. It's right now you can see it in Indonesia, in the south of Spain, Granada, Cordoba, Sevilla. And sure, here you can put watermelon in the water to make it cold while you are smoking shisha. And this is another example too. And there's something nice in Aleppo, or remember, I think, in Aleppo, yes, no more water, so they will make it not so much deep, you don't so much throw water also. Here, like Concilia of Syria, alphabet, completely musical note. And also in Mari, in Syria was the first chamber of commerce, which related to trade. And also the first building was also in Syria, in Mari Kingdom, about to help poor people also. And also there is workshops for perfumes. And also the the old orchestra collection, let's say like more than 7 person who are playing music also. And this is actually, there's a program they will make a review with me, it's so important. Most European thing, Muslims don't care about archaeological sites. So here in these 3 points, I just wanted to give 3 examples how Muslims, really Muslims, were treated with non-Muslim buildings. If we go to the just 60 kilometers west of Palmyra, you will see Qasr al-Hir al-Gharbi, the Western castle, which back to Umayyad period, and it was Byzantine tower, so Muslims didn't destroy, just completed. And also the theater of Busra, actually without the Ayyubid fortress or buildings, you will not see the chair of the fans, and the basilt chairs also. Also in Aleppo, there's steel cross and Al-Halawiyya Mosque. Still Muslims also don't destroy it. So I don't know how ISIS or else like think it's we have to destroy it. No, it's not that way. Since the last thing, here this is finishing text, which we discovered it in Brazil actually. Before Christopher Columbus, we know American, South of America by Phoenicians, they are right there. So it's stuck the same story as Phoenicians in the world, they are like the original maybe of Syrian, sure, not exactly. So also had it the same when also he said that because of the heroin in the sea, we succeed to see most of the world for 2 years, but so hard storm because of Baal, God Baal, which made us like separated, and we came here, they mean Brazil, but for all Syrians, maybe for Germany, coastal or Dutch coastal. So we came here with 12 men and 3 women to the new ocean by me, the king, the captain, and we wish from gods to care about us. And that's all.